main reason that women come into the bars is economic. You know, they come because they need money to support their families. In Thailand, as in many countries, the women are the primary ones who raise funds for their parents, for their siblings, for their children, for their relatives, sometimes even for their boyfriends or husbands. So all the pressure is on the women. So that's kind of, you know, the final point at which that pushes them into the work. But beneath that, there are so many other issues that are the push factors. There's the cultural issues. There's the religious beliefs. There are family pressures. There's the self-image. There's the fact that the majority of women in prostitution were already sexually abused, verbally abused, physically abused, rejected, even early in childhood. And so all of those issues are beneath the surface. When they come to Nightlight, when they come out of the bars, they're not just dealing with the experiences of prostitution, but you're dealing with everything that's beneath the surface. So it's not enough just to give them a job. Some people think, well, we'll just give them jobs, you know, we'll just refer them to us and we'll give them a job in a company or in an office or in a restaurant. But it's not enough. They'll go there, all of the issues of the past are still there. And all the lies in their head about who they are, and that will, those are things that will pull them back into prostitution. So we work with them holistically. We have the business and we also have a nonprofit that work together, integrated on a day-to-day basis. We start every morning with worship. And worship is where the women experience God. You know, they experience His presence. They don't have the words, the vocabulary to know who God is. They've not been taught that. But they feel His presence. And they feel a love, they feel a warmth, and they begin to be drawn to Him. And then we have classes that explain Jesus 101, who Jesus is, Jesus 102. And as they come to faith, there are electives, you know, classes for discipleship or for growing in their faith. We have a therapy type of group called Heart Group, where the women who are believers will come together in groups, and there's kind of like a peer counseling where they can work through issues of breaking ungodly soul ties, of dealing with idol worship, ancestral worship, family pressures, abortion, rejection, all of those issues that they can actually deal with those together with a supervisor, with a pastor. We also started a church for the women. We started for the women. But as a result of starting that, the women bring their husbands, their boyfriends, their children, their neighbors, their relatives, their friends. And so the church is growing, and we're seeing that we're having not just an impact on the woman in her own personal life, but we're having an impact on her family, on her marriage, on her community that way. So we've seen, as a result of that, we've seen men come to Christ, and men being baptized, and men starting to grow in their understanding of who they are and their leadership in their family, as well as in the church and in their communities.